Welcome back to Ive at the Hive, live audience edition. Yeah! All right, for those of you who don't know who I am, my name is Jesse Peters, a current MSW student at Boise State University. Most of you may know me as Jesse, the social work intern, but I'm now Jesse, the social worker. All right. All right, well, we've got some great talent tonight, and I don't just mean me. Okay, we got James the Plane Wreck and Absa's Sin-Hand Memories. So without further ado, James Plane Wreck, let's get the show on the road. Woo!
Socks, let's raise our heads, use the endless flow, timely desperate. Right where they are to be, we won't hurt ourselves. No violence will last for help, you'll see. We may be nowhere, but there's nowhere else I'd rather be. We may be nowhere, but there's nowhere else I'd. I'll raise my bones to the broken parts. I tear my soul apart. In lies, I know I'm wrong. There will be lies and there will be something. Oh, we go to the lies and lovers and headaches, heartaches do come. So go on, be free. For those liars and lovers, headaches and heartaches like me. I'll raise up, ready to go. In the end, I wait for. Well, I'm jacked, I'm ready to die. In the end, I wait for. We tell our bodies, our toes, our hearts. We hate our lives. That we tell our bodies, our toes, our hearts. We tear it all apart. We wreck it all, my God. So go be young. Avoid those liars and lovers, headaches and heartaches too. So go on, be free. For those liars and lovers, headaches and heartaches like me. There'll be your eyes and everything will go. We're all sound asleep waiting for the growth. Oh. riots up, we bottle them up. Racing cats, we go. I ain't worried about everything we know. We tell ourselves the end is come. Riots, race, and go. We got a lot to blame. We are. Go, go, go.
So the first time, first show Dustin played with us was here last year. And now this is his fourth show with us, because that's how often we get booked during this time. He's great. We love him.
Oh, thanks.
He's only a rental.
Are you good for a rental?
About $250.
With insurance.
I race in the dark, let the riots in. I was coming back as caustic now as I've ever been. Come back home for you to tell me those riots are all in my mind. Like it or not, we know you really don't wanna die. You just let those little riots run wild. Say what you want, say what you need. 'Cause I'm a little boy, something's as hot as it used to be. Oh, oh, oh. My mind belittles all the good things left in proportion into how much I've had to drink. You just let those little riots drink for free. Tell ourselves we got nothing but time. That ain't right. We tell ourselves we got nothing but time. That ain't right. Cause nobody wants to wake up to the rest of their life.
Yeah.
go when we're alive. So it doesn't hurt. Oh, great. We're in a bad place. Hey, hey. Walls are closing in. Everything's a sin. All this is hard. Sight to sink. Yeah, I'm ill prepared. I'm what to think. Closing in, everything's a sin. This is harder when the riots begin. C'est la vie, people come and go. That's a grace, and so we go, we go. C'est la vie, we'll come and go. Riots in the grace, and so we go. Everything we've ever done, from suicide attempts to bad birthdays. the higher half sound of your first drum. Let's drink, woke ghost. No greed, no God, no hope. Burn your hands, cover me. We rise, we bleed. We got everything we need. Still got holes, got sound to feed. Let's address that elephant that follows me to every fucking group. Surround the gray, sit hot, silhouettes, clouds in semi dark. We rise and fall to the graceful spot. I want you to know that your worries are my worries too. Black string to old ghosts. No greed, no God, no hope. Burn and cover me. We rise, we bleed. We got everything we need. Still got holes, got sound to feed. I've come to terms with my. There'll be things I've never seen. There'll be story arcs I wrote in my mind. I threw out before the first scene. Drunk and sing, how to clean everything, top of our lungs. Hands around the bottle, knowing glances and everything we've ever done.
Z can be cured.
Maybe a drink and a head start. Praise will be heat and the seas will bark. Got the one that got away. got the one. Yeah, I'm tired. And the hits keep coming.
All right, this song's about how this is Dustin's last show and he doesn't know it yet.
Yep. Sorry.
Here we go. Here we go. You're not needed on this one. No, you're doing great. You guys are doing great. I love these guys with all of my heart. They're my best friends on earth. I love you. Nothing ever seems to work. A little touch never works out quite right. I can take what I can take. I don't know this time. I've gotten pretty good at the waking up. Trouble is with the carrying on. Some days all it takes to break. I'm stupid, you said. I'm simple, you said. The gaslight coming on.
It should be my last day.
You surround yourself with stained glass, so you can drink yourself to the dirt. Whatever gets you through, whatever works.
Drink yourself to the dirt.
whatever gets you through. Whatever works, I can be the same as I was. You can be better off. Be what I was. Makes it closer out today. Simple life. This is love. So I can be what I was. Darling, this is all. Who can rise and go?
Thank you guys so much. Thank you for having us. We love this place. It's amazing.
One of the things that I had trouble with when I was growing up in Boise was finding musical resources and finding places to feel like I could express that and develop in that way.
Having a Musicians Resource Center in Boise has been a unique type of environment.
It's a very relaxed, amazing resource. I just kind of fell in love with it. It offers so much and so little people know about it.
My first impression of the Hive was, this seems like a pretty cool open space. There's a band jamming and they were playing and I was coming to talk about volunteering.
Hey guys, we're all listening to Nature. We're gonna start a writing or something.
Well, I was trying to find a band and some people to play with, and well, I showed up to the Hive and well, I'm in a band.
There's a better community here. A lot of different bands and a lot of people who are starting music, but then also a lot of people who've done music for a long time. And we all like seem to get together even though we have such differences, and it works out really good.
I know I've talked to multiple people in multiple bands that have said that having a low cost space to be able to practice and be able to rehearse their sets and even just meet people and try stuff out has been really valuable for them.
That's part of the culture of the Hive. It's just a really positive experience of mentorship and collaboration.
There's a lot of kids that are like in high school that can't come to some of our shows in downtown because everything's 21 plus.
It's like an all ages sober environment, no matter like what day of the week it is or like how late it is.
People are really excited to have an opportunity to show what they've worked on and what they're accomplishing, and there's a lot of original music.
The Hive is ran on volunteers and donations, and I feel like everybody has the ability to give one of those. You have time, you have resources, even old equipment. It'll get used in some way. I feel like everybody, if they really knew what this place did, they'd want to help out more.
It's incredibly important to have things like this and to give musicians, especially young musicians, access to things like this so they can feel like there is something there for them.
Metal. Hey, thanks.
This is Ann Padilla from the Boise Hive. During coronavirus times, we want you to know at the Boise Hive that we are here for you. This has been a long 2 months for a lot of folks. A lot of people have lost their jobs, and a lot of people are isolated. And you know, if you have had trauma in the past, this pandemic is going to probably accentuate some of that trauma. We want you to know that we're here to help you. You may not know during these times that if you happen to sign up for the Medicaid Affordable Care Act that had open enrollment in November and December of 2018 and 2019, you are eligible for mental health services. We at the Hive would like to get those people who don't know that they have this to counseling if they so desire. One thing that we are taught when working with suicidal people or people that we think may be suicidal is to listen. Listen and observe the person that you are interested in or concerned about. The other thing is to ask hard questions. It's really true that people do not feel safe or comfortable asking the hard question of, are you suicidal? I think most of us are unsure about that because we don't know what we would do when somebody says yes. One thing you can do is you can call the Idaho Suicide Hotline, and that the people there will walk you through what to do next. If it's emergent, you could call 911 and have somebody go for a welfare check on the person that you're concerned about.
I just want to see you. I just want to be with you. No more running away. No more games to play. I'm falling for you. I just wanna hold you and whisper I'll always be true. No more running away, no more games to play. I'm falling and I said, no more running away, no more games to play. I'm falling for you. So much life to live, I wanna live it with you. So much love to give, I wanna give it to you.
play solo stuff, and my name's Aaron Smith, and that's not very catchy. Okay. So I went with something a little more pizzazzy.
Yeah.
It used to be James Pizzazz.
Okay.
And then it slowly moved on.
Nice.
Jazz Pizzazz. What's wrong with that? Jazz Pizzazz.
Yeah, for sure.
Jazz Pizzazz.
And then it stuck. It's a stupid name. All band names are stupid.
Yep.
Forever.
All right, so what does the Boise Hive mean to you? What brings you here?
Oh, this place is amazing. If we had a place like this growing up, it would have been so cool. Just to come in, be able to rent instruments. You guys charge almost nothing for people to play. And, you know, it was practicing in garages and getting cops called on us. And, yeah, this is an amazing thing you guys do. Yeah, it means a lot to play here.
Yeah, for sure. Alrighty. So how would you guys describe the Boise sound? Are you guys from Boise?
Yeah. God, I think we're all... You were not born here.
I was born in Boise. Yeah.
Okay. Andrew was born in Montana.
Okay.
Dustin?
Yeah, I wasn't born.
He wasn't born. Justin, yeah. Justin is yet to exist.
I've yet to hatch.
God, growing up, it was punk rock mostly, you know. Now it's wildly varied. You got synth pop, you got this burgeoning metal scene. We got a lot of great metal bands. Yeah, there's a lot of cool bands around here now.
Yeah. There's a lot of diversity too, which is great.
Yeah,
I appreciate the diversity.
Yeah, for sure.
That's coming from four white dudes in a
band. No, that's all right. Yeah. All right, so how would you guys describe your sound?
Pop first, probably.
Okay.
Then some old, like the guitar-driven, like indie rock of the
90s.
Oh, yeah. Little punk influence in there. And, yeah.
Maybe some classic rock, too.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Pussy grabbing. Is that what you're
describing?
All right. So just gonna walk away.
We're real great with interviews.
Yeah, that's all right. We'll blip that part out. Okay, so here at the Hive, it's not just about the music; it's also about mental health and suicide awareness. So, guys, how has suicide personally impacted you?
My dad. Brother-in-law, sister-in-law, it's made a huge impact on my life. It shaped pretty much most of my adulthood. And, you know, it's especially back then, there was a stigma about it. And that's lessened quite a bit now. And just talk to people, man. My dad was a farmer from the Midwest who would never talk about his feelings. And, you know, because there's always a stigma there. And now it's... the more we can talk about it, the more we can help people, you know, because as hard as things are, they get better. Everything gets better. You know, we've all been at the lowest point and thought about it, but it always gets better.
Yep, I know. No, talking about our feelings is hard, and now you've got a guy you've just met asking you to talk about your feelings. Alrighty. Well, with this whole pandemic, we have all had... Hey, Peanut Nook Gallery. Okay. Quiet. Thank you.
I'm dropping some real knowledge here. God.
All right. So, guys, so during this past pandemic, how did you all maintain your personal health? Okay.
For the better. It was for the better. Yeah. You know, my lady and I were in the house with a 5-year-old all year.
Okay.
It was trying, but we got there. You know, just help each other out, you know, tell each other what you need. You know, be honest, open with each other. And, you know, if you need some time away, go take some time away. You know?
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. Yeah. You guys?
Anything? All right.
Sorry.
Okay. Yeah. No. That's all right. I mean, we all love playing music in front of people, but for this past year, that's been really hard. Yeah. So it's good, and it's a shout out to everyone. Maintain your personal health. If you need help, reach it out to us. All right. So guys, so how have you let your emotions impact your songwriting?
Oh, that's every song. They're catharsis. Mm-hmm. I don't even think I'd play music if I didn't, you know, have big feelings. I just don't know where to put them. And I write songs before I ever know what they're actually about. You know, you can take a year sometimes and you look back and like, oh, I was going through some things right there. But they're always personal.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, yeah, it shapes everything.
All right, cool. And then when people listen to your music, how do you expect them to feel?
Hopefully good.
Yeah.
Hopefully, you know, surface level, you know, it's a rock song. And then hopefully they'll actually dig in a little bit and hear the nuances. And we work really hard to put, like, you know, subtle little things in there. And, yeah, I just hope they enjoy it. And anyone who spends a minute of their time listening to us, thank you from the bottom of my heart. It's a big thing.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah. All right. Well, guys, I have one last question, Chin, for you. Where can people go to hear your music?
JamesPlaneWreck.com. That is not a thing. Bandcamp.com/JamesPlaneWreck. We're on Spotify. We're on YouTube. Yeah.
Pornhub.
Yep, sweet.
Amazon. Most of the standard streaming sites.
Yeah. Awesome. Alrighty, well, we have just heard from the band James Plainwreck. Up next, we have Abscess and Memory, so stay tuned, and we'll be right back.
pull up, buddy, drop the steel. Won't you come and tell me how you really feel? Man, it's murder. Whoa, it's murder. Pull up, buddy, drop the steel. Won't you come and tell me how you really feel? Man, it's murder. Whoa, it's murder. Woke up one day in this cage, but his hands caught a DUI. Most of them good cops, but some of them wanna see you die. Put down the bottle, I cut down a refi. And I want no plastic, complain of PCP. Throw hands and we learn nothing about speed. If talk once was cheap, in the Badlands it's free. Never felt right till I got this mind clean. Form a line of rhyme schemes, we define the fine thing. Watching the day saying, take them guns away. What you wanna be a slave, man, come on. Word to the wise, tell them not to watch outside. Stand tall and together stay strong. Buddy, drop the steel. Won't you come and tell me how you really feel? Man, it's murder. Whoa, it's murder. Mr. Officer, knuckle up, buddy, drop the steel. Won't you come and tell me how you really feel? It's murder. Whoa, it's murder. Yeah, 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 it's murder.
Things that I had trouble with when I was growing up in Boise was finding musical resources and finding places to feel like I could express that and develop in that way.
Having a Musicians Resource Center in Boise has been a unique type of environment.
It's a very relaxed, amazing resource. I just kind of fell in love with it. It offers so much and so little people know about it.
My first impression of the Hive was, this seems like a pretty cool open space. There's a band jamming and they were playing and I was coming to talk about volunteering.
Hey guys, we're all listening to Nature. We're going to start a writing
or something. I was trying to find a band and some people to play with, and well, I showed up to the Hive and well, I'm in a band.
There's a better community here. A lot of different bands and a lot of people who are starting music, but then also a lot of people who have done music for a long time. And we all like seem to get together even though we have such differences, and it works out really good.
I know I've talked to multiple people in multiple bands that have said that having a low cost space to be able to practice and be able to rehearse their sets and even just meet people and try stuff out has been really valuable for them.
That's part of the culture of the Hive. It's just the really positive experience of mentorship and collaboration.
There's a lot of kids that are like in high school that can't come to some of our shows in downtown because everything's 21 plus.
It's like an all ages sober environment, no matter like what day of the week it is or like how late it is.
People are really excited to have an opportunity to show what they've worked on and what they're accomplishing, and there's a lot of original music.
The Hive is ran on volunteers and donations, and I feel like everybody has the ability to give one of those. You have time, you have resources, even old equipment. It'll get used in some way. I feel like everybody, if they really knew what this place did, they'd want to help out more.
It's incredibly important to have things like this and to give musicians, especially young musicians, access to things like this so they can feel like there is something there for them.
I'm not gonna hide, I'm not gonna hide, I'm not
Welcome back to Live at the Hive. Up next, we have the band Abscess in Memories. And as you can tell, the band is anxious just to play. So let's just hear them, all right? All right, and we've got Abscess in Memories. Let's get this show on the road.
How we doing, Boise? All right, thank you for coming out. We're Absent Memories. We hope you like the show.
Hope you're ready for the same song.
Yeah, it's the same one we just played. All right.
Free.
Thank you.
Does anyone know where an extra drumstick might be?
It could be in the green room. Maybe. Oh, yeah, there's some right there. On your hi-hat. All right. On you, big dog. We'll be right back.
baby, don't go.
Thank you again. Yes? How are we doing tonight, Boise? It's good to be back together with everybody. Friends. All right, boys. We good to go? Maybe. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
Oh no. The double bass? Brought the single Tama. Thank you. Should we throw the other one on?
Hey, do you guys have an extra double bass pedal? Mine just snapped.
Yeah, my pedal busted too.
A double bass pedal? He rocked too hard. This is why we call him the Thunder God 5000.
Yeah, we have merch at the table.
Yeah, there is merch at the table if you're interested in the EP that just dropped today. So, yeah. None of these ones are on there. We don't even know what these songs are called we're playing, so.
The good ones are on there.
Yeah, but there's some good ones on there, yeah. We haven't played that yet. All right. Tune? Huh? I know.
My pedal busted.
Which one?
This one.
Aye, aye, aye. Possibly. Yeah, it's getting sweaty. Wherever people want us to play, we'll play. But we don't have anything set yet, do we? He's more of the aficionado when it comes to knowing where we're playing.
We submitted our stuff to Tree Fort, but
yeah.
Just alternates at this point.
Yeah, Tree Fort,
Tree Fort, if you want us to come play, we will play.
Should we just go to the single pedal?
So we don't have another double bass.
Okay.
But we've got other pedals.
Yeah, okay. Thank you, kind sir. What's the shredder? Yeah, cool. We will. Yeah, like I said, we're not picky. Yeah, it's a glued double bass pedal. It's really cool. It sounds really cool. It just breaks, you know? Yeah. What do you do?
Oh.
Yeah. Yeah. I've been saying this for a while, man. I've been saying it for a while. Yeah, me and Christopher. The only prescription is more cowbell. I'm telling you guys, you're gonna want the cowbell on the track. Cool? Well, you'll just have to be like John Bonham and not cheat, Connor. We'll be right back.
Thank you.
For some very mediocre drumming compared to what you have heard to this point now. We're going from like John Bonham to like maybe Ringo, maybe. Yes. From the beat, get it. And now, it's time for the EP that just released, ladies and gentlemen. Check it out on Spotify or any of your other streaming, whatever you call it these days. Yeah, there's CDs on the back table as well as stickers and shirts. Pretty cool t-shirts. All right, boys. It's pretty cool t-shirts. They're white, too, so they're you're good for everything. Yeah. Hey, see you, James. Yeah, you can make it a crop top and then use the rag. Yeah. That's my shirt. All right. Good. A little dip, you know.
sense of where. Did they take your soul, baby? No. Thank you.
Sunny, yeah.
Where were you?
Imagine. Here's the single. You got it, bud.
Right on memory.
Yeah, I'm writing things under confusion. When there's rights on memory land, ask me a question about my shadow of a man. My love was born in the hands of a woman. And baby, it was my fault.
The man wrote that song when he was just a wee lad.
Life gets tough sometimes.
Yeah, riots on memory lane. Yeah.
We wrote this song about our friend and his mishap with a woman.
Yeah, this next one is fun.
Thank you.
good. Thank you. We thank you guys for coming out. We're absent memories, and that's all the songs we know. So. But yeah, thank you. We greatly appreciate it. Drive safe. Have fun. Not too much fun, but maybe too much fun. I don't know.
Remember when to say when.
Huh? Remember when to, yeah, remember when to say when. Yeah, check out the merch. Check out the EP. It's fun stuff.
The surprise. What?
Confident or miserable.
You
can't seem to settle down. When you feel like crying every night and every day.
Crying every night and every day.
I got something to say. I can't believe you got nothing to say. I got something to say.
You got nothing to say.
Why don't
we go out for the walk? We gotta get a little exercise. I wonder.
My name is Ann Padilla. I'm a board member at the Boise Hive and the mental health coordinator there as well. A big part of our population is at risk. Men, in particular, are at a higher risk from 20 to 70 years old are at a higher risk of actually completing suicide. Things you might not know about the Hive is that the whole agency was started for musicians who were underinsured, not only underinsured, but had no resources to go to, and so it was people that came together that were noticing suicide in their community amongst musicians, and that's why the Boise Hive was started. We want to take on this issue of the mental health stigma and people reaching out. We find that people who reach out for their mental health are actually stronger for doing so, but that is not necessarily how our culture sees it. We still have that age-old idea that people have to do this alone.
And we're back with Live at the Hive. My name is Jesse Peters, and tonight I have the band Absence Synth Memories. So guys, your band name reminds me of this past year with the pandemic, especially for musicians, because by not being able to play music, those are memories that you didn't get to have. Ergo, absence and memories. Yeah. Am I right? Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So where did you guys get that band name?
I think that's an interesting question.
That was me and music reminds you about things you forgot about, and yeah. You know, there's people that have Alzheimer's and they'll lose their memory, but when you put music on for them, it's like they come back a little bit. Yeah. So I just felt like it was shows how powerful music can be.
Yeah, I work with Alzheimer's patients, and I concur. All right, so what does the Boise Hive mean to you? What brought you guys here?
So I actually petitioned them to try to get a show here because I came here to try to be an intern, actually with you, and just didn't work out. But I like what the Boise Hive does for local musicians and young people, so I thought it'd be a great way to kind of help out and also put our name out there.
Yeah. Good. Yeah. That's right, guys. Sal Padilla, social worker. Mm-hmm. Remember that.
He's also a social worker.
Yeah. All right. So, how would you guys describe the Boise sound?
The Boise sound.
Yeah.
Eclectic.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, Connor's been in the scene longer than any of us. What would you say?
He's the expert. I mean, I think it's always changing. It kind of changed with the trends that happened nationally, but it's kind of more of a grassroots movement, I would say, than probably some other cities.
Okay. Awesome. Now, how would you guys describe your sound?
I would say we are a cross between, like,
classic rock,
metal drums, and a little bit of Blink-182.
Okay.
And that's just all me right there.
I like to say, in the words of Angus Young, we're just rock and roll.
That's right. In the name of rock, we salute you. Okay. Okay. All right. Okay. We're going to get a little deep here for a second. So here at the Hive, it's not just about the music. It's also about suicide and mental health. So guys, how has suicide personally impacted you?
Well, I mean, I kind of struggle with mental health myself. That's one of the reasons why I kind of steered towards a social work profession. And I feel like music has been my outlet and it's helped me creatively, mentally, and it's been a way of self-care. And I can only speak for myself.
Yep. Awesome.
Anybody else?
I mean, yeah, I thankfully have never had problems. Thankfully I've never had problems like that, but I've known people, friends that have dealt with that. And it's tragic sometimes if you don't take care of it, but yeah. Just be aware of people, you know? Just the golden rule, treat people how you want to be treated, man.
That's right. Yeah. All right. Alrighty, so this has been a really hard year for all of us, especially for musicians who can't play in live spaces. So guys, during this pandemic, when you're not able to play music, how do you maintain your mental health and your personal well-being?
I would hop in the party chat on PS4 with all my friends, and sometimes I wouldn't even be playing video games. My headset would just be on, and I at least got to hear. I'd get to hear somebody and talk to somebody, and that's about it.
if I could, I mean, I feel like during the lockdown and everything, it really helped us be more creative with our music. Because I feel like a lot of our originals came from being in that lockdown. And it also gave us ideas and also gave us time to work on our craft on these songs. And in the end, this is kind of the working product here.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah. All right, and then going off of that, there is an old quote, "From the ashes of disaster grow the roses of success." All right, so... Yeah, that's right. All right, so guys, how have you let your emotions impact your songwriting?
I mean, the song Starting Over, the slow one, I mean, it's about me getting my heart broken, so, I mean, there's one way.
I mean, I think all songs revolve around emotion, so it's kind of, you know, kind of like the happier song, you know, it's kind of like you were...
in a good mood, or you know, there's more somber songs. There's, you know, it's kind of, I mean, they all reflect emotion.
Be true to yourself, man. Don't try to fake. Yeah, don't try to fake anything. You know, if you're feeling sad, write a sad song. It feels good.
I think music is kind of a safe space where you can just say whatever you want to say. And it's kind of ambiguous, too, because what means to me can mean something else for somebody else. Like, the songs aren't just what means to me. It can be whatever. Like, what it means to me can mean something completely different to somebody else.
Alrighty, so when people listen to your music, how do you expect or how do you hope for them to feel?
Sometimes I want them not to like it because bad publicity is good publicity. And other times I'd like to just see that I was able to like push them to feel something, you know, because I try to write a little open-ended in terms that I can write what I feel, but I can also let someone else feel what they might feel through that and take it in their own way, and it's not so direct into what I was thinking.
Well said. All right, so guys, I have one last question, Chin, for you. Where can people go to hear your music?
We're available on Spotify. EP's been released as of an hour ago. You guys can stream it there. Apple Music, we're on Amazon. We're on iTunes. You can go to absentmemories.com, buy your merch. You can do a digital download there. I mean, really wherever music's available. You guys have anything to say?
Sal said it.
Alrighty, well, we have just heard from the band Absent Memories, and this is Live at the Hive. We'll see you next time.
Discretion.